I'm here to talk about a motoring icon of the 60s that simply won't go away. No, I'm not talking about myself. I'm talking about the Mini Cooper.
The new Mini Cooper is music to my ears. We've had a lot of fun together over the years, I can tell you.
But this latest offering, the Sport 5, has something just that little bit extra. It comes direct from the man who created the Mini Cooper, John Cooper himself.
Coopers are one of the great names in the history of British motor racing. They won the Formula One World Championship 2 years running. But in 1961, John Cooper was to create the company's most famous car, the Mini Cooper. And he's still at it with the latest range of Cooper S's. So how did it all start?
When the Mini actually came out, all my drivers, Brabham, Salvadori, McLaren and myself, we put Formula Junior engines in the car, and they handled so well. It was the first 10-foot long four-seater saloon car that handled like a sports car. Issy Gonis wasn't too keen at the beginning, but he got used to the idea, because Issy Gonis loved motor racing, really. But he used to always make out he didn't, you know.
So John persuaded the bigwigs at BMC, and the Mini Cooper was born.
We realised the capabilities of the car, and we thought, we've got to make a real homologation special now and really go for it. And we put the 1070 engine in. That was the one we called the S. That was the car that came out in 1963, and Paddy won the Monte Carlo Rally in 64.
When Paddy Hopcote won that Monte Carlo, I mean, it was absolute national news, wasn't it?
Well, and I couldn't believe it, you know. It was absolutely, because to me at that time, the Monte Carlo was the rally to win.
Of course, when we used to do competition, we used to love the Mini Coopers because you could do things like this in them. Or this. Fantastic, just like the old days.
But of course, this car is really intended for road use.
Now, nobody would ever call a Mini Cooper a motorway car, but we have one now, because this is the first Mini Cooper to be fitted with a 5-speed gearbox as standard. So here we go, up into fifth. It's a Jack Knight gearbox that is fitted, and a very famous name in gearbox building, used to build all the gearboxes for the old Cooper racing cars. Yeah, the sound level is quite acceptable here now. We're just doing 70 miles an hour, about 3,000 revs. And very pleasant. Well, you can certainly feel the extra power on this car. It's about 30% more than the standard Mini Cooper, which takes it up to 85 brake horsepower, and that's all been done by the modifications done at the John Cooper garage. It certainly feels really powerful, and those slightly bigger wheels are putting it down on the road well. Well, there's no mistaking this handling. This is the Mini Cooper. Very direct steering. No power assistance, of course, but you can feel the little wheels scrabbling for grip there. The steering wheel, just the same. It's so direct, it's absolutely marvellous. The steering wheel's a bit chunkier than the old days, but of course we've got an airbag in it now, which is a very good thing. Now, the price of this car on the road from John Cooper is £12,995. Now, for that sort of money, you could probably get something a lot more sophisticated, a lot more comfortable, but I guarantee you could not get anything that's any more fun to drive. Look at this, wonderful.
In 10 minutes, I was a callow youth again. I was in heaven, me driving a Mini Cooper S containing John Cooper himself.
We're kicking off with another series of The Car's the Star, but first we need your help. We want to hear your tales, your anecdotes and your urban folklore of cars like the MGB. And we're not talking an intense nightlife greasing your hub carriers, but weird, wacky and wonderful personal experiences. The new series highlights some of the best-loved cars in the world, like the voluptuous Jaguar E-Type. That perm in steel can still make a pretty girl smile. Surely there's someone out there who could fill a little black book with caddish tales of the bosomy Jag. Or perhaps you spent the 60s in a kibbutz with flowers in your hair. If you did, you almost certainly burned joss sticks in the back of one of these. Love and peace to all, the VW Camper. Or maybe you were a bank manager in a reversible Mack with a Rover 2000. If you, your raincoat and your Rover led a riotous life, then let us know. Or how about America's only sports car? Did you ever rumble down the King's Road, raising the eyebrows of the highbrows in a Chevrolet Corvette? If so, we want to hear your tales. Likewise, the car you always promised yourself, the Ford Capri. If you were a minder, a professional, or just a plain old getaway driver, then call us now. And finally, you've just seen that old swinger that's still swinging the miraculous Mini. There must be bus queues of you out there with mad memories of Mini Mania. If so, you know who to call. So if any of these old motors trips a switch in your head, ring us now on 0121 471 2939. Or you can write to us at The Cars The Star, BBC Pebble Mill, Birmingham, B5 7QQ. And fear not, we'll be flagging that number up again at the end of the programme.